I absolutely loved the first day of school.
I remember I got a trapper keeper and I was very, very excited.
And they let me ride my bike to and from school, and I thought it was the coolest thing ever.
This last year, when my son started a new school for kindergarten, and there was something really special about the first day, knowing that this is a school that goes from kindergarten through 12. We started making friends day one with certain other families, and it was like, wow, they could be together for 12 years.
Yeah. I don't know. The kids are always usually very excited. New backpacks, you know, like that kind of thing. It's always a new outfit, new backpacks. We always take pictures, you know, of course, first day, last day. You know, it's usually interesting to always see those pictures like back to back, you know. But I don't think we're gonna have that sort of normal back to school this year.
Yeah, I guess it would be kind of shopping for all my school supplies and stuff. You know, oddly enough, I was physically handicapped as a kid for a lot of my childhood. So those years, you know, in a way, I'm going to turn this into a good thing, but in a way, those were really, really tough, you know, because I wore this big metal contraption on the lower half of my body for most of my young life. And so going to the first day of school was really, really, really tricky, but man, it made me into the person I am today. So really, I'm going to transform that kind of tricky memory of going back to school for personally into something that really empowered me to be who I am today. So in a way, I'll say that's my favorite.
We didn't have much money growing up, but I remember we had enough money one school year where I got a. Do you remember Trapper Keeper notebooks? I remember I got a Trapper Keeper and I was very, very excited to rip that Velcro open.
My mom used to take me to Neiman's for school clothes shopping from Tulsa to Dallas, and I could pick one thing. And for me, that meant a lot to me. It was our time together. We rode down there. I could pick one thing, and then we had lunch and rode back. And that's a great memory.
I don't know exactly what year it was, but I do remember that I had just gotten a bike like during the summer. I was super excited, had my new school outfit, and my parents let me ride my bike to school, which like they usually didn't do that because I wasn't very good, but I worked on it all summer. I got really good at riding my bike, and they let me ride my bike to and from school, and I thought it was the coolest thing ever. But then I don't think I ever did it again. So I was like, it's kind of hot. I got a little sweaty. But for the day, it was like the best thing I had ever done.
You know, getting ready for football practice early in the morning at 7 o'clock, you know, an hour and a half before the bell's gonna ring for that first class, and be out there in the field with the coach and the team and everybody going, okay, man, if you do this, you do your part, I'll do my part, we'll execute this play and win the game. And that's kind of a lesson that we all need to carry in life. It's not the game that you go out and win the game. It's play by play, play by play. It happens one play at a time. As a baseball catcher, the game was never won in 9 innings. The game was won one pitch at a time, one pitch at a time, one swing at a time. When you're the batter, you step up to the plate, first of all. If you don't step up to the plate, you definitely ain't gonna get a hit.
I just remember always the night before going back to school, making sure I put together the right outfit. Because I didn't want to be like, all right, I got new clothes and I wanted to show off. So I kind of mixed something old with new, you know, but my trainers or my sneakers, whatever you want to call them, they were always like the main focus because I would build the outfit from there. But it would always be like, because I went to school, I actually look like a polo ad going to school because that's what I wore in, you know, in junior high school and high school. So long before I even got a chance to work for the brand. So I was pretty preppy when I went to school, and it always started with what shoe I was going to wear that was going to make the outfit.
I absolutely loved the first day of school because I felt like, as a little kid especially, like in elementary school, you feel like you've been gone for so long. You come back and you think everybody's going to change. And so you're super interested in like what their summers brought them, what they did, what they experienced. And you just want to hear all these stories. And then like you see friends again for the first time in a while. I always love the first day of school. And this just the excitement around everybody getting back together again. Now that I'm older, summer break doesn't seem that long. Back then it felt like forever.
I just can't wait to see him light up. he loved his school so much that when we would drive down the street and he would vaguely see the yellow building, he would clap, he would cheer, he would get so happy to see his Miss Sophie, his teacher. I just can't wait to see that happiness on his face again and for him to be surrounded by kids.
I remember Noel in New York when we lived in that grand townhouse. He would come down the stairs in his jacket and tie and be like, "Mom, really? Do I have to go back to school today?" And he hated wearing a jacket because he grew up in Switzerland and in the country in the Hamptons. And then all of a sudden he was in New York and it was very, you know, formal. And so he hated putting on that jacket the first day of school.
I think it was, for my kids, for me, it was the last day that they were all in elementary school at the same time. It was like, one was a sixth grader, one was a kindergartner, and I think he was like in third grade. And they all got off the school bus together, and I knew it was gonna be like the last day I'd ever see all three of my children like come off the bus, and it was just cute. They were like little ducklings coming to their mama.